Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel, Trendonomics by Associates. So today I'm going to discuss about Nifty Bank Nifty, the market outlook. But before that, first of all, I would like to thank you for wonderful support. We are getting more views, but it's not enough. We want to reach more and more people. So subscribe to this free YouTube channel. If you still haven't, subscribe, share, like, comment, follow me on Twitter. This is my Twitter handle, @HustleKid84, where I share stock market updates. For live market updates, you must follow me on Twitter because that's where you'll get a real market analysis. So follow me there. If you used to learn Elliott Waves, we have a recorded webinar just for 999 where I've discussed all the patterns, motive waves, corrective waves, how to spot opportunities in different asset classes, how to spot highest probability trading opportunities, how to identify major turning points, ride big waves, how you can boost your confidence, improve your trading, how to use combination of tools like moving average, RSI, Fibonacci trend line, trend channels, and because that's how is Elliott Wave works, because this is not a rocket science. We use traditional technical analysis tools, and I've also discussed the common mistake people do, how to avoid them. I'm also giving ebook on Elliott Wave principle, free ebook. So just register from my blog Trendonomics or my pinned tweet. Okay, even if you don't register for a webinar, but don't forget to get this free ebook on Elliott Waves, because I'm giving this ebook for free to everyone, whether you register or don't register for a webinar. So get the access that book from link in description. And today I'm also going to discuss about the basic structure on Elliott Waves. So now discuss Nifty. So as discussed, we are into the fifth wave. We have been discussing it all over. If you are watching me regularly, we haven't changed our wave counts. Yes, because we stick to the counts unless and until market proves them wrong. So this is clear cut five wave rally. Wave one ended in May near 9900. Then we had a fall towards 8800 and then a steep rally towards 11,800 in wave three. A fourth wave correction in September towards 10,790. And from there, we are into the fifth wave, which is further extending. So from 10,790 in September, late September, we had first wave one around 1200 points move towards 12,020. Then we had a dip towards 11,530 before the US election results. And then we had this steep rise from 11,530 to almost 13,770. That's extending that third wave. And then we got that Monday fall of 600 points. Knee-jerk reaction in fourth wave. Yes, definitely. When you have a extended third, yes, we had this rise, a steep rise without any meaningful correction. So definitely a shock comes in fourth wave as per Elliott Wave. So we got that shock in fourth wave, a 600 points dip. And then from there, we are up again. We are at new highs. But price-wise, yes, price-wise, we are again up about 800 points from the low of 13,130. But price-wise, we are still not done equality to wave one. Wave one was about 1,230 points. And right now, we are done about 900 points now. So, yes, we still might do another 300. Or we may not do it because fifth waves are tricky. But one thing is clear, one thing is sure, that this is the fifth wave and there is no doubt or confusion in that. This is fifth wave from the low of 10,790. And again, we are in fifth wave from the low of 13,130. And there is no confusion. There is no doubt on that. And we are most likely to end this fifth wave on 4th of Jan. Yes, that's the highest probability now. Of course, I will discuss why. I have already discussed it in yesterday's video, but today again, I will discuss it. So, a fifth, that's the final wave that started after that 600 points dip. And then we are about now 7 days, we are in uptrend. This rally was 14 days, about 14 days rally and 1200 points move. We are 7 days and 900 points move. Till Monday, it will be 9 days. Yes, 9 days. And definitely when the third wave is extended, then either fifth wave achieves equality to first, or sometimes it may truncate, I won't say truncation because we are already above that previous high of 13,770, but it may fall short of, it may not achieve equality to wave one, because we had a super extended third wave without any meaningful correction. We are up, we got almost 2000 plus points rally from 11,500 to 13,770. So almost to 2200 points rally without a meaningful correction. That's a steep ascent. Yes. So in March, we had this steep fall. In March, it looked like we are not going to go up again. And same is the case now. Now people have got that view. People have got the belief that we are not going to go down anymore. People are thinking that, yes, we could have a correction like this. We had on Monday, 600 points. So we could have a correction, but that will be the deep buying opportunity. That's the thinking of masses right now. And definitely at this point, we must be careful. We must be careful. Definitely, one must be thinking why I'm so much bearish. Why I'm sounding so much bearish? Yes, definitely. We had been a little bit wrong. We had been wrong because we are ideally expecting top of wave 5 near 13,300 in December itself. But almost now we are reaching in January. So almost it's been a month that we were expecting this move to end. But definitely in fifth wave extension, it happens like that only. Market keeps extending for a longer time than we expect it to top out. But at certain point of time now this is that certain point of time, we are now much probably, much there is a high probability we will reverse this trend. Yes, because it's now clear the dip was fourth wave shock after this 2200 points rally, 600 points drop. That was a shock in wave 4, and we are back up again. And now there is a loss of momentum. Yes, there is a divergence, and I discussed that the divergence will remain. Even if we go above 14,000, so definitely this average, even if we go to 14,070, that's the 76% Fibonacci ratio of wave one, that's from 10,790 to 12,025. 76% Fibonacci proportion comes near 14,075. So that's probably the resistance. Yes, we should not be looking at resistance here, but if we we must consider Fibonacci ratios now, because in fifth wave, that's how we calculate fifth wave targets or fifth wave resistances. So 14,075 on upside might act as a resistance, and then we might reverse on 4th of Jan. Why 4th of Jan? Again, 61% in terms of time. Yes, definitely. One must also consider time extensions. So 61% of this move in wave one in terms of dates comes on 4th of January. Again, we have a important GAN reversal day as per GAN cycles. Usually tops are made, not tops, tops or bottoms are made near 4th of January. And January is usually a bearish month. That everyone knows, definitely everyone knows that January is usually bearish. So does market again oblige the seasonality? Why not? We are almost 6,000 points up, rather we are 7,000 points up now, just 500 points short of that 7,000 points move. We have 6,500 points up from the V's in from the lows in March. We are into fifth wave and we are pretty much overbought on daily, on weekly. We are RSI of 76, so that's definitely overbought trading. If you see market cycles over last 20-30 years, the major tops have been done at the RSI reading, weekly RSI readings near 80s. Yes, definitely it can go towards 80. We are just 76, but we must be careful now. We are in overbought zone. Okay, and so this is the fifth wave for sure. I'm not going to change. Some analysts are saying that this is first of third, then this was second of third. We are in three of three. And again, after correction, we will go up. That's the alternate view by other analysts. I'm not going to change my account. I never change my account unless and until a market proves me wrong. I stick to my analysis. I always stick to my analysis. Yeah, so even in June to August, when a lot of people were doubting this rally, I had a clear view that this is the third wave and we are likely to go much above 12,500, the Jan highs. That was very much clear and I stick to that view. And now I will stick to my view that this is fifth wave and definitely we are going for a trend reversal, and which is most likely on Monday itself. So in yesterday's video, I discussed that we might get a couple of dojis more before we top out on Monday and before we drop, we get that trend reversal. Why? Again, I discussed that even before this fall of 600 points, we had a couple of dojis. We had a couple of dojis formation and then we got this sudden dip. So now also we are getting hammers, dojis, hanging man candlesticks. So we have three dojis so far. Right now, and this is taking a U shape, a kind of curve. So most likely, if we are going for the reversal, we might get that a U shape curve when we fall off. That's how usually tops are made. If you see in Jan also, January top, we had that curve before we made that top of Jan. See, this is the curve before the January top, where the momentum feds, a loss of momentum. Clearly, over here we saw that loss of momentum. So again, here we are seeing that loss of momentum. And so I discussed that on hourly charts. I discussed probably we had wave 1, 2 and then extended third wave ended yesterday. Day before yesterday. And then we had that fourth wave correction. And in fifth wave, we are likely to form an ending diagonal. And so far it is coming true because if we see the this move from yesterday's low of 13,860, this is pretty much corrective move. This is definitely not a impulse rally. And yes, definitely in fifth wave, mostly in where when we are near the end of move, usually market forms ending diagonals because that's how market traps bulls and bears on both sides. And then market actually goes in distribution mode before actually it stops out. So even here you can see before this fall, before the 600 points fall, market was moving in a range, and then it gave that sudden drop. So again, over here, market is moving in a range, and we are most likely to continue till Monday, 4th of Jan, because January usually bearish month as per seasonality. Tops are made on Monday. Why Monday? Because at start of week, at the starting point of week, really no one is expecting that market will change the trend or market will go down. There will be a trend reversal. No one actually expects that when we are in uptrend. So usually tops are formed on Monday. If you see all the major tops, they were formed on Monday, whether this top of 12,430, or you see this top August, that was Tuesday, even this top was Tuesday. Again, in 2008, 2010, most of the tops are formed on Mondays. So this Monday, Jan being the seasonally bearish month, and we have that event. We have event of again, Trump, US elections, recounting and everything. So we have that event coming up, which might be the trigger for the fall. Yes, definitely. We need a trigger fall. So that event might be a trigger. We don't know what will be the trigger, but charts are suggesting we are into fifth wave, and we are likely to go down once we break down from this trend. Consolidation, rising wedge, or ending diagonal. Again, tomorrow we might find support of this trend line or moving average, which is 13,872, or previous day low. Yesterday's lows was 13,860. So we are going to get the support near that level, and we may again bounce off towards 14,060 to 70 on January 4th. And then finally make a top. Yes, currently I'm not looking at any alternate wavecon because I usually don't go for alternate wavecons and say that, okay, we had said that if this, not this, then that. We don't do that. I stick to my views. I only change my view when market proves me wrong. So this is fifth wave. And most likely it will end on Monday. We have a negative divergence in Bank Nifty. Bank Nifty again, we have a five wave rallies, a wave one, two, then three. And we had a fourth wave, a flat correction. And then again, we are in fifth wave, which is probably we might test near 32,000 because. Banks may catch up because Bank Nifty has not made a new high above the Jan high. So maybe it might try to catch up and may go near the highs of January. So 32,000 levels, 32,000 to 32,200. That might be the level where Bank Nifty might top out. Overall, broad market is showing weakness. As I've already discussed, auto not making new highs. Nifty metal index, again, not making any new highs. So broad market is weak. Clearly, it's showing weakness. Even mid-cap index, Nifty mid-cap 100, again, refusing to make any new highs. So definitely, that's the sign of weakness from broad market. Intermarket divergence, we have that intermarket divergence. Okay, I will discuss why I'm so much bearish. So I will discuss the basic structure of Elliott waves. So this is the basic structure of Elliott wave. A five-wave rally. So after a five-wave rally, we will always have a three-wave fall, and it's always like that. So we are near the end of wave one, a five-wave rally, one, two, three, four, five. So So we are into fifth wave, and whenever we end this, we will have that wave two correction before market resumes the uptrend in third wave. So even if in this 5 wave rally, you can see that after wave one we had wave two correction, then three, again wave four correction, and after finishing this fifth wave, we have a 3 wave correction, and we are now near end of this fifth wave. So this is the cycle in every wave, in every impulse wave. That's wave one, three, and five. You will find a 5 wave rally, and in corrective waves, that's two and four, you will find a 3 wave fall. And the structure continues on all time frames, whether it's daily, hourly, or even if you see 5 minute chart, you will see this Elliott wave structure. So now we are on a major cycle. On a weekly chart, we are completing this 5 wave rally from March. So we will have that wave two correction before we start going higher again. That's how I'm bearish. So we have this 5 wave rally from March low, and once we end this rally, we will have a deeper correction. That's why I'm sounding so much bearish. Definitely, we cannot say precisely when this fifth wave will end, but now, currently, we have that probability in next week. Mostly, we might end this. We don't know. We might end tomorrow as well, because we already have dojis. But usually, tops are made on Monday, so we'll wait for Monday unless until a market starts going below previous day low. So usually, for a trend change or close below previous day low, that would be a sign of trend reversal on short term. So currently, 13,860, that's the level one should be watching for, below which we can expect a trend reversal, or this trend line, or this moving average, which is currently at 13,880. But yes, this swing low is more important, 13,860. So watch out for the support if we get again bounce back towards the ha these highs. So Monday is the day where I will be expecting a trend reversal, Monday morning. I'm not going to short before that, unless until we break these lows or we break this moving average, then definitely I would start shorting, but not before Monday. Definitely we might get ending diagonal, because this structure is not complete. This is not a 5 wave move, and this does not even look like completion of ending diagonal. This just looks a 3 wave move. So probably we have just completed A, then we will have B, then C, D, E. So most likely we have completed A wave, and then a fall in B, and then after C, D, and E. That might end on Monday, 4th of Jan. That's where I will be looking for a trend reversal. Definitely in first hour on Monday, I will look for a trend reversal signal. If we see this formation, ending diagonal formation, this is currently just a 3 wave rise. So I won't say that this rally is over yet. We have two more legs on upside pending, probably, before we end this move. So keep watch on these levels. On downside, definitely 13,860 to 880, and on upside 14,070. If you like this video, you can share it with your friends, and keep watching this channel, because I'm going to discuss more and more every day about the trends in market, and I'll discuss Nifty, Bank Nifty, and overall markets. So keep watching, keep sharing, and subscribe to this free channel and hit notification bell. That's how you're going to receive notification whenever I post. And also follow me on Twitter for live market updates. You can follow me on Instagram, because on Instagram I post a lot of trading psychology quotes, and I post a lot of charts of stocks also, and of a variety of instruments like dollar index or gold, silver, much more. And I post about trading psychology. I post ideas on investments, finance. So follow me there, Trendonomics by Harsh Dixit. That's my Instagram handle. And yes, definitely keep sharing. Share this video with your friends if you liked, and hit the like button, hit the notification bell. Keep sharing and keep learning. This is Harsh Dixit signing off. Until we meet again.